إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، أو نبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، محمد بن عبد الله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه، in his final Hajj, the year 10 AH, with hundreds and thousands of his companions in front of him, the last Rasul of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he asks his Sahaba, his companions, what day is this? And they say that this is the sacred day. He asks, and what month is this? They answer, the sacred month. He asks them, and what place is this? This is the sacred place. And so he then says, إِنَّ دِمَاءَكُمْ وَأَمْوَالَكُمْ وَأَعْرَاضَكُمْ حَرَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ كَحُرْمَةِ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا فِي شَهْرِكُمْ هَذَا فِي بَلَدِكُمْ هَذَا. Verily your honor, your dignity, your wealth, your property, it is all sanctified like this place, like this day, and like this month. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam beautifully put it, and he said, Al-Muslim, the definition of the Muslim, Al-Muslim, man salim al-Muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadih, that the Muslim is the one who other Muslims are safe from his tongue and safe from his hands. Rawahu al-Bukhari. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, how many times have we used this tongue in the service of our nafs and shaitan? How many times have we used this tongue to split between brothers, to split between families, between individuals? How many times, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, that the same tongue, same lisan, which we use to recite the kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we use it to break ties, that we use it for ghibah, and we use it for namima, and we use it for lies and deception. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, our gatherings, when the brothers gather, when the sisters gather, when we gather together, be it after Jumu'ah, be it before Jumu'ah, be it before the Salah, after the Salah, be it on social media, how many times our gatherings are only but ghibah and namima and backbiting and talking bad about this one and that one to fulfill our own inadequacies. Allahu musta'an. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, how many hearts have we cut? How many hearts have we sliced with our tongues? So slippery is that tongue, but how fast it is to cut up the tongues of individuals and cut up the hearts of individuals. Brothers and sisters, if whatever we say, even if it was true, then it is ghibah, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. And if it is false, then it is slander upon our brothers and upon our sisters. And unfortunately, many a times, the ones that we talk bad about, the ones that we gossip about, they are who? They are from amongst the best of the people. They are from amongst the du'at. They are from amongst the ulama. They are from amongst those sisters who are looking after their chastity and they are trying to live a good life, and still we pick left, right and center. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, listen carefully to the story of Ma'iz radiallahu ta'ala an. Ma'iz was a companion of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sahabi, who's his teacher? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Which madrasa did he go to? Masjid al-Nabawi. Who were his friends? Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman and Ali and the rest of them. But Ma'iz was a human being. and he fell short. He fell into the traps of temptation and he fell into zina. But subhanAllah, maybe the difference between them and us, very quick to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ma'is comes, Ya Rasulullah, tahirni, purify me. 4 times he testified against himself. Nobody knew about his sin, committed in the darkness of the night. But he could not live with that sin. He wanted it sorted out in this dunya before the hereafter. Ya Rasulullah, tahirni. Is he majnoon? Is he insane? Is he drunk? Ya Rasulullah, he's not drunk. He's not insane. 4 times he testified against himself until the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave the order for the capital punishment to be applied upon him. And they took him and they applied the punishment upon him. Brothers and sisters, this was a man who fell into zina. This was a man who was guilty of adultery. But after this was done, 2 companions speaking to one another, they said that, look at Ma'iz, what a disgraceful death he died. He died like a dog. What a disgraceful death. Nobody knew about his sin. Why did he publicize it and die like this, stoned in public? Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah. Our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he overheard this, the hadith in Abu Dawood, he said to both these individuals, can you see the dead carcass lying there? Can you see that animal which is lying dead for a few days? It is smelling, it is stinking, it is decomposing. Go and eat from it. They said, Ya Rasulullah, how can we even get close to it? How can we eat from that? Our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that you're speaking bad about Ma'iz is worse than both of you eating from the dead carcass. And right now Ma'iz is swimming in the rivers of paradise. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, whose defense did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam take? He took the defense of an individual who was guilty of adultery, 100% guilty, and he had the punishment applied upon him in public. How many times we talk bad about people, we slander this one and we backbite that one, and we don't even know the reality of the matter. We don't know whether it is true, whether it's false, whether it's a mere rumor. What is the matter about it? How often we pass on messages on social media as received. We forward the messages. We don't know whether true, whether untrue, whether in reality it is something that should busy me in the first place. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah. They came to the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They said, Ya Rasulullah, I have this female neighbor and she fasts a lot and she stands up in prayer a lot and she gives a lot in charity, but her neighbors are not free from her tongue. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there's no good in her. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, there's another female neighbor. She doesn't make any extra salawat. She doesn't give any much charity and she does not fast that much, but her neighbors are free from her tongue. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that she is in paradise. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, the qissa of the Ghamidiyya female. She comes, Ya Rasulullah, purify me. Just like Ma'iz, he turns away from her. He doesn't want to know about it. He turns away from her sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She says, Ya Rasulullah, are you turning away from me like you turned away from Ma'iz? Look, I am pregnant. She also fell into the sin of zina. One might say, what temptation did they have at that time in comparison to the fitna and facade that we see around ourselves, left, right and center? But they were insane. They were human beings and they fell into error. كُلُّ بَنِي آدَمَ خَطَّى وَخَيْرُ خَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. Every pious person has a past and every sinner has an opportunity in the future. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her, go, come back once you give birth. 9 months later, she might come back. And then she comes back. She says, Ya Rasulullah, I've given birth. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells her, go. Once the kid can eat on his own, then bring him. Maybe 2 years, subhanAllah, if we go with the full period of weaning. 2 years later, people have been born, people have died, the world has moved on. But she knows, Allah knows, Allah knows. And after that period of time, she comes back, Ya Rasulullah, you remember my incident. Here's my kid, he can eat on his own. Imagine the mother, she's now parting from her child. There were no policemen outside her house to make sure she would come back. But she knows, Allah knows. And she's made her tawbah, walhamdulillah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave the order for the capital punishment to be applied upon her. And they took her While she was being stoned, some blood splattered on the face and heart of Khalid ibn Walid. And Khalid ibn Walid, he said a bad word about her. Something bad about this woman. How could she do this? What a major crime, what a major sin. How could she fall into zina? Where is her honor? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard about this, brothers and sisters. Our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that she's made a tawbah, it would suffice in some narrations for 60 men of Medina al-Munawwara. And in another narration, for 70 men of Medina al-Munawwara. Subhanallah. Both incidents, brothers and sisters, our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took the defense of people who were 100% guilty of adultery, and he still stood in their defense. How often we spread lies, how often we speak bad, how often it's a mere rumor which does not even concern me. Min husni islamil mar'i tarkuhu ma la ya'ni. From the beauty of a person's Islam is that they leave off those matters which do not concern them. Ya Abdullah, ya Amat Allah, with regards to our parents, did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, not say in the noble Quran, وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفْ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. Do not even say uff with regards to them. How often? A million times worse than uff we say. How often have we even spoken to them with a good word? Ya Abdullah, ya Amat Allah, how sad it is that our friends and our pals, they are the ones who have our good company, but not our parents. Brothers and sisters, the man came to the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, Man ahaqqu an-nas bi husni sahabati. Who's the best person? Who's the person who I'm supposed to be best to in this world? Ummuka, your mother. Thumma man, then who? Ummuka. Thumma man, then who? Ummuka. Thumma man, thumma abuk, and then your father. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, three times, your mother, your mother, your mother, and the fourth time he said your father. Allahu musta'an. Ya Abdullah, ya Amat Allah, how many times have we made them tear? How many times have we said those bad words to them? How many months and days have gone by? We have not brought happiness to their lives. May Allah forgive us. May Allah forgive us. May Allah grant us tawfiq to have control over our tongues. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our tongues instruments of good. May Allah make our tongues instruments of miftah al-khair. They said to Luqman al-Hakim, O Luqman, this animal has been slaughtered. Bring me the best two organs of this animal. And he brought the tongue and he brought the heart. Then the man said to him, O Luqman, bring for me the worst organs of this animal. And he brought again the tongue and the heart. And they said, how come? He said, because the tongue and the heart, if they are good and pure, then they are the best. And if they are impure, if they are bad, then they are the worst of organs. May Allah grant us tawfiq. May Allah grant us khair. May Allah grant us the ability to be silent. And if we are unable to be silent, for us to say good. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد عباد الله قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من يضمن لي ما بين لحيه وما بين فخذيه أضمنه الجنة. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever guarantees me whatever is between his jawbones, whatever is between his lips and between his thighs, then I guarantee for him Jannah. One might think, mashaAllah, so easy. Jannah is guaranteed if I protect my tongue and if I protect my privates. But subhanAllah, brothers and sisters, you all know that it is a jihad. No doubt, it is a jihad to hold back from talking when you want to talk bad about this one and that one. And why do we fall into ghiba and namima and all of this? Why do we criticize? Why are we armchair critics? Because many a times, We want to fulfill our own inadequacies. Because I feel I'm not so good. I'm not like this and I'm not like that. I'm not like so and so. So if I lesser their daraja, if I bring them down, then I feel that I am better. Allah musta'an. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, the one who criticizes left, right and center, the one who picks, the one who talks ghiba and namima. And how often it is that sometimes you enter into a majlis and the brothers are talking or the sisters are talking for 20 minutes, 30 minutes. You don't want to involve yourself in ghiba and namima, but subhanallah, that's what they are talking about. After you leave that gathering, you feel physically sick. Why? Because all that they were discussing was the eating of the flesh of our brothers and sisters. The entire gathering was about this one and that one and that individual. They suffer from the syndrome, أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْ. The disease, أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْ. I am better than so and so. And who is the one who had this disease first? None other than Iblis. He said with regards to our father, أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْ. خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ طِينٍ. I am better than him. I am better than Adam. I was created from fire and he was created from dust. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, the Salaf, Umar radiallahu ta'ala an, he would fear hypocrisy for himself. Umar the giant would fear hypocrisy for himself. They were worried with regards to themselves. They would state, خَلِّ الذُّنُوبَ صَغِيرَهَا وَكَبِيرَهَا ذَاكَ التُّقَى وَاصْنَعْ كَمَاشٍ فَوْقَ أَرْضِ الشَّوْكِ يَحْذُرُ مَا يَرَى لَا تَحْقِرَنَّ صَغِيرَةً إِنَّ الْجِبَالَ مِنَ الْحَصَى. That's leave off sinning small and big. Don't look down upon small sins. Be like the person walking a path and he's worried where he puts his feet. He does not get pricked here. He does not fall onto the rocks there. The thorns don't poke him here. Do not look down upon those sins, for verily the mountains are made up of small tiny stones. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah. Another reason that we eat the flesh of our brothers and sisters is because we engage in those matters which do not concern us at all. Subhanallah, how often it is on social media, somebody asks a question. You don't have any knowledge with regards to the matter, but subhanallah, in the age of opinion, everybody has an opinion. And so we start commenting, this one and that one and this one. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, we do not want to be muflis on Yawm al-Qiyamah. We do not want to come with mountains of good deeds. وَشَتَمَ هَذَا, and we swore this one. وَسَفَكَ دَمَ هَذَا, and we spilt the blood of this one. And we made ghiba of this one and that one and spoke bad about this one and that one. And they come one by one to Allah and they seek the huquq and they take away all of our good deeds. What a loss. What a loss on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Allah musta'an. And if we do not suffice, then they come and they take away all of our good deeds. And then they put onto us all of their bad deeds. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us tawfiq to protect our lips, to protect our tongues. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, we do not want to be like those who are the muflis on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Mu'adh, وَهَلْ يَكُبُّ النَّاسِ فِي النَّارَ عَلَى وُجُوهِهِمْ إِلَّا حَصَائِدُ أَلْسِنَتِهِمْ. Oh Mu'adh, hold on to your tongue. Hold on to your tongue, Ya Rasulullah. Will people enter the hellfire due to their tongue? Yes, Ya Mu'adh. And will people not be flung into the hellfire face first because of what they earned with their tongues? إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ لَيَتَكَلَّمْ بِالْكَلِمَةِ. Maybe a servant, he speaks a kalima, a word. مَا يَتَبَيَّنُ فِيهَا. He does not think about what he is saying. يَزِلُّ بِهَا فِي النَّارِ أَبْعَدْ مَا بَيْنَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ. And he goes into the hellfire deeper and more further than the east and the west. اللهم طهر قلوبنا. اللهم طهر قلوبنا وألسنتنا. اللهم احفظ قلوبنا واحفظ ألسنتنا. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين. O Allah, protect our tongues. O Allah, forgive our sins. O Allah, those sins committed with our tongues. O Allah, forgive us. O Allah, make us the true Muslims. من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. That Muslim which other Muslims are safe from our tongues and safe from our hands. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان، اللهم انصرهم، اللهم احفظهم يا رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. أقم الصلاة.